Razia might have warned me about that. I suppose if I were 1,000 years old, I'd forget things too. Like giant collapsing staircases that could kill people. You could have warned me the stairs were dangerous.
What happened?
They collapsed under my feet.
I am sorry. The city has been abandoned for many centuries. I have been here so long, I did not think of it.
Is there anything else you haven't thought of? Like perhaps a way for me to save my brother?
You tried to stop him, didn't you? Despite what I said.
Of course I did.
Then you know I told you the truth. Your brother is gone.
I know he is not himself, but that he cannot be saved. How can I trust what you say? I know nothing about you.
I know very little about you either, son of Sharaman, brother of Malik. And yet I must trust you to end what your brother has started.
Why do you care? You're one of the Jinn. Your kind are all but immortal.
Ratash was once one of my own people. If we do not succeed here, he will destroy everything I have ever cared about, and the things I have sworn to protect, including this kingdom.
Why do you need me? Why not do it yourself?
I have my part to play.
And what is that?
Do you truly not trust me? Or are you simply angry because you know what must be done and are afraid to face it?
When I was younger, my father was often away at war. It was Malik who first taught me to hold a sword. How can I fight him?
It is not your brother that you fight. It is Ratash.
I know that. It doesn't make things any easier. You are right. Ratash and his army must be stopped. Tell me what I need to do.
The city is in ruins. You will not pass through it on your own. Hotrotahodra. I have given you my memories of this place. They will help you see the city as it once was. Go on. I will meet you at the temple. Once it was home of the Marid, the greatest of the tribes of the Djinn. You will be able to see some of its glory. Beyond this wall is the temple. I will meet you there. Tribes of the Djinn. Before the army came, this was one of our greatest cities.
What happened here?
When King Solomon formed his empire, he allied with the four tribes of Djinn. We worked together to create cities, the likes of which had never been seen. My people, the Marid, moved rivers, created aqueducts. We kept the waters flowing, bringing life to the desert. But some of us hated that human and djinn should work together. And the first among them was Ratash. He resented King Solomon and vowed to destroy his empire. Ratash combined his powers with the desert sand and wind to create an army. It was an abomination, a desecration of all that our powers had ever created. When the army attacked, King Solomon and the four tribes banded together to stop it. It was a massacre. The army grew even as we fought it. It was as endless as the sand itself. Finally, a way was found to imprison it within the seal, but not before many died, human and djinn. Very few of my people survived the battle. Of those who remained, most left the city, vowing to stay far away from the army, even though it was sealed away. And now, I am the only one left.
Why do you stay here?
Rakem stands in the reservoir that feeds the city above us. I swore to King Solomon that I would guard the water. Without it, the kingdom above would die. I did not realize I had been here so long. I believe I told you, time passes differently for the djinn. It was not until I felt the army's release that I realized so much had been lost.
Razia! Razia!
Thank you.
It seems the army's power is interfering with my own. This is not something I have seen before. We should move on before something worse happens.
Thank you.
I spent many hours here learning statecraft. That was so long ago.
Most of my days in the throne room, I was trying to sneak away. Malik was the responsible one. How will I explain to our father what happened here?
You will tell the truth. Ratash killed your brother and tried to destroy this kingdom. And you saved it.
We should keep moving.
Yes. There is a...
You see? What did I tell you? Not that you can hear me.
If you can still hear me, that door leads to a sanctuary. I will open it for you, but you must get rid of these things. This is the origin of the city's water source. Without it, this place would have become a desert long ago. It is this that I have stayed to guard. How do they dare enter here? The sword you seek is behind that statue. When the statue faces the vault, it will open.
Is that King Solomon?
Yes.
It is odd to think you knew a man I have heard of only in legend.
I cannot imagine your legends do him justice. He was a wise ruler and a kind man. You asked me why I stayed here. Even had I wanted to leave, I could not abandon the city he called home. Even now, it is difficult to think of it.
But you're not leaving. Razia? That's usually not a good sign.
statue faces the vault, it will open.
Any part of Malik is still alive. I hope he will forgive me for this.
Are you prepared? I do not think we should delay much longer.
I'm ready, but my own sword barely caught that Ratash's attention. How will this one stop him or the army?
This sword was built for this purpose. To destroy what one djinn has created requires the magic of another.
I don't understand.
Give me the sword. I will show you. Kodratajin Azanatobad.
Razia!
I am all right.
What did you do?
I told you I had a part in this. With my power, you will be able to attack Ratash.
What will happen to you when he is gone?
I do not know. We will see when you defeat him. Now we must go. This is for nothing if you cannot destroy the army.
Thank you.
I suppose we must find Malik.
I do not think that will be difficult. Even now, I can feel the strength of the army.
Then we'd better hurry. Unsettling to have one's sword comment on a battle.
It is also rather unsettling to be the sword in a battle.